children, now let us continue with the lesson play with the magnets. So now let us discuss about poles of a bar magnet. Poles of a bar magnet. So in this, for this you have to do an activity to know about the poles. So what you have to do, already we done one activity, how to separate the iron filings from the soil. We have collected the sample of the soil and in that we just kept the magnet and kept in the soil, and some of the iron particles which are present in the soil are attracted to the magnet. So after attracting to the magnet, those iron particles should be removed separately. After removing separately, collecting one paper. Collect those iron particles in one paper. After collecting iron particles, below you have to place the magnet. So suppose you think you have collected some of the iron particles on the paper, below you have to place the magnet and you have to rotate it. So when you rotate it below, what happens? Some of the changes appears here. These iron fillings, they change their position. The more iron fillings will be towards the end of the magnet, and only some particles will be in the middle of the magnet. Only some particles. The more iron particles will be towards the end of the poles of the magnet. Those are attracted towards the pole, moves towards the poles of the magnet. This shows that there is a pole. There is a pole. You call it as a pole. One you call it as a north pole, and another one you call it as a south pole. Okay. By this activity, you come to know that more the iron fillings are more attracted when you collect a bar magnet. The iron fillings are attracted towards the end of the two poles. End of the two poles. This we call it as a pole. Two ends. Towards the two ends of a bar magnet. These two ends of a bar magnet are called as poles. They are called as what? Poles. These ends are called poles of the magnet. This is the bar magnet. These ends are called the poles of the bar magnet. Now let us learn about another activity, finding directions with bar magnet. So how to find directions with bar magnet? So how to do this activity, I'll explain now. So for this you have to collect a strand. After collecting a strand, tie a magnet with the help of a thread. Tie a magnet. After tying a magnet, color the magnet and write one side, one end write it as north, another end write as south. Tie it with the thread and color this. After coloring it, next what you have to do is just after writing north and south, that is the direction. After tying it with the thread to the stand, leave it as it is. Here it moves somewhat. Keep it in a place. Keep it in a place. After keeping it in a place, just leave it for rest. After leaving it for rest, this bar magnet, it comes to the rest and it stops its movement. When it stops its movement, after stopping the movement, what it shows? It shows the directions of north and south. After stopping it, just see the direction and see what is written on the bar magnet. Where is north and where is south? See. Then you can find the direction with the help of this bar magnet. And repeat this experiment not only one place, keep it in the change of places. Like if you kept in some one place, change in place and keep it in another place and see the movement. After moving up, see the position of the bar vibrator. When it comes to the rest, just see the direction of a north and south. Is there any changes or not? Observe it. Here, magnets always comes in the direction of north and south. Always comes in the rest position, that is north and south direction. Here, the marked portion represents the marked portion of the entity represents the north direction and is called as the north pole of the magnet, and the south is called as the south pole, and this property is called a directional property. This property is called a directional property. It's called as directional property. Here, this magnet always comes to the rest in the north and south direction. The marked point always points towards the north direction. The marked point, whatever you are marking there, it points always towards the north direction. And another one, so it is called as the north pole, and the south is called as the south pole. This property is called as a directional property of the magnet. And we use this property to make the magnetic compass. As everyone has seen the magnetic compass setting where it shows the direction of north and south. When it shows the direction of north and south, easily you can recognize which is east and which is west by seeing the direction in the magnetic compass. Okay, next let us discuss about the magnetic compass. Magnetic compass. Here, this magnetic compass, it is like a clock where the pointed end indicates the north and another end indicates the south, and the meaning it indicates east west, and here it indicates northeast northwest, and here southeast southwest. This is the model of a magnetic compass, and wherever you keep it, it will show the direction of north, south, east and west. So where this magnetic compass is used actually, and how it is made? This magnetic compass is inside a magnet is used actually, inside a small magnet is used, and on that a small needle is placed. So this needle with a pointed end, it indicates the north direction, and opposite it indicates the south direction. And even easily you can identify which is east, which is west, and which is northeast, northwest, southeast, southwest. Easily you can identify other directions. So where it is used actually? Where it is used? Uses of compass. Okay, the uses of compass are, it is used in ships, airplanes and mountainous. Mountainous, they carry compass to know the direction so that they should not miss from their places. And army people also, they carry compass. So this is the uses of compass. And one more thing you have to remember, you have to note it, that magnet and compass should not be placed together. Means you should not keep the magnet and compass together at the same place. So next we learn another activity, attraction and repulsion between two magnets. So for this, what you have to do, you have to take two bar magnets. When you take two bar magnets, for that first you have to place in the position of north and north direction, means same north and north direction. So when you place the two magnet in the same north and north direction, they are not attracting each other. Instead of attracting, they are moving from their place. You can see it here very easily in this video. See it, I am trying to touch it, but they are not attracting, they are changing their places, it is moving. So next what you do, you just change the position. Change the position, one you keep it in the north, another you just turn its position in the south. So after changing its position, just try to attract it. See, it is attracting here. The bar magnet attracts each other. North and here, by this, what you can do is, what do you observe in this activity? You observe that here both the poles, north and north pole, are not attracting together. Here what takes place here? Repulsion takes place. North and north pole, repulsion. Repulsion takes place. So, when you take north and south pole, when you take the direction of the north and south pole, here attraction takes place. Attraction of the magnet takes place. And next what you have to do, another one is south and north. South and north. Just change the direction in the south and north. South and north. Here you can see the attraction of the magnet. Next, change the position into south and south. Change the position of the bar magnet into south and south direction. South and south direction. Here repulsion takes place. The magnet is not attract each other. So repulsion takes place. So by this activity you learn that here north and north poles, and another one is south and south poles, they repel each other. They repel each other. So they are called as what? Like poles. Like poles repel each other. Repel each other. And here another one is, when you change the position of the bar magnet into north and south, and another one is south and north, they attract each other. Here unlike poles, they are called as what? Unlike poles. Unlike poles attract each other. Attract each other. Your like poles repel each other, that is north and north, south and south. They are called as the like poles because their directions are same, so they are called as like poles. They repel each other, means they will not attract each other, so they are called as repel. They repel each other. And here north and south direction and south and north direction of the bar magnet, they are called as unlike poles. They are called as unlike poles. So they attract each other. So in this activity you learned about attraction and repulsion between two magnets. So now let us learn about Earth as a magnet. So before going to this, already we learned in one activity that the suspended bar magnet always comes to rest in the north and south direction. North and south direction. So as you all know that the suspended bar magnet always comes to rest in the north and south direction. Why does it come to rest in that particular direction only? Why does this bar magnet comes to rest in the north and south direction only? And what force is acting on this bar magnet? Now let us try to find out what force is acting on this bar magnet. So to find about this, let us perform one of the activity. To perform this activity, you have to collect two bar magnets. to bar magnets. One bar magnet, you have to place it on the table. You think this is a table? Place one bar magnet on the table, and this bar magnet, place it in the north and south direction. After placing it, take another bar magnet, tie it with a thread, hold it in your hand, and try to keep in the north and south direction only. And bring this near to this magnet which is kept on the table. Bring this bar magnet near to another bar magnet which is kept on the table. So when you bring it near, what happens? It changes its position. It changes its position into the, this is called as a suspended magnet. The bar magnet which you are holding in your hand, this is called as suspended bar magnet. Suspended bar magnet. So when you bring it closer to the bar magnet which is kept on the table, this is suspended bar magnet, it changes its position. So your north direction of the magnet, north pole of the bar magnet changes its position into south, and south position of the suspended bar magnet changes its position into north. So like this it changes its position. Here some doubt may be arising in your mind that why this bar magnet changes its position. Here some force is acting between these two magnets which we can't see. That force is called as the some of the magnetic force which enable this suspended bar magnet to change its position. So here we can say that where this force comes from and where this force comes from, it is from the earth. By this we can come to know earth acts as a magnet. Your earth, some force which is present in the earth, and somehow that is called as a magnetic force. Your magnetic force present even in the earth also. Because of that force only, this is suspended bar magnet, it changes its position into north to south, south to north. And again what you do, just remove the bar magnet which is kept on the table. After removing the bar magnet which is kept on the table, again this suspended bar magnet, it changes its position into north and south. North and south. So by this we will come to know that some force is acting which enables this bar magnet to change its position. So that force, where it comes from the earth. So by this we can say earth as a magnet. Okay, now let us learn about another activity, finding out whether the given object is a magnet or not. So for this you have to perform an activity. Let me do this now. Here I collected three objects. One is sharp piece, another one is sharp knife, and another one is compass. So now I'll try to take the bar magnet. I'll try whether these are taking attraction, which what is taking place between these two. Attraction is taking place or repulsion is taking place. Now let us see here. So this is the bar magnet. I have taken a compass. See this, here attraction takes place, and if I just changing the position of this bar magnet, here also attraction takes place. And not only this, I am changing even the direction of this compass. I am trying to put it wherever I need, but here attraction takes place for this compass. Like this means here this magnet, it attracts iron particles. Not only this, I am taken even another bar magnet, and along with this even I have collected even a this ring magnet also. Ring magnet, this is the ring magnet. This also I am trying it. See how it attracts this compass. Their attraction is taking this for this compass. Now I am trying with another object. The another object is chalk piece. This is chalk piece. I am trying to attract this with a bar magnet, but it is not attracting it. Here repulsion is taking place. It is not attracting it actually. It does not attract. and another one is sharpener. Here, this is sharpener. Inside the sharpener, there is a blade. This blade attracts the magnet in all the directions, not only one, but in all the direction it attracts. But this plastic, it is not attracting. So what will conclude by this activity? By this activity we conclude that while like iron objects like compox, it attracted the magnet. But the remaining like sharpener and compox, this is the sharpener and chalk piece, they are not attracting the magnet. This only this is attracting the magnet. Here, if not only that, if you change the position of the bar magnet and if you try to bring it close to this, it is attracting in all the directions.